Hello and welcome to this video for Schoolhouse Test 4. As you can see, I'm using the Schoolhouse Test 4 Professional Edition, and today I'm going to be setting up a simple table question. Just a quick mention, both the table question and the table design item work similarly. But when you're working with the table question, it gets numbered like the other questions get numbered, and you can also add you can set the cells up so that they have answers. Whereas with the table design item, you can set up maybe something for reference, but it doesn't get numbered and it doesn't have a way to provide answers when you turn the answer key on. Alright, so as you can see, I've already clicked table and set up my first table question here. And what I'm going to do is make just a quick multiplication table. And you can see by default that there are two rows and two columns. And if I go into document view, I can see that set up there. What I want to do is create a table that is 4x4, four rows, four columns, and one column and one row will be sort of my headers, will have information in them for the multiplication. So I'm going to click Edit Table, and by default I'm taken to the columns, and if I click here I'm taken to rows. Now, one of the things that I will just emphasize here is that most of the time the formatting for rows will override the formatting for columns. So the formatting for rows by default will always override the formatting for columns unless I check this setting for a column that says override row settings. And you can see here, I'm just going to resize this a little bit. You can see when I click on one of these settings here, whether it's in the row or in the column, you get just quick little definition in here about what you're working with. So if I want the formatting for my column to override the formatting for the rows, then what I need to do is check here. You can name your columns, you can name your rows. For the simple test or table that I'm setting up, I'm not going to bother doing that. I'm just going to go with column 1, column 2, column 3, column 4. And I'm going to start setting up my first column now. The first column will have my information to set up the multiplication question. So it's going to have some specific settings. And so first of all, it's going to override row settings. It's not going to be an answer column, it's just going to have data. And probably I'm going to want it to be about, let's say 15%. We can adjust that later, but approximately 15% of what the table is. And let's just, just to show you how this works, I'm going to set up the alignment as center, and I'm going to give it a background color just so that it's easier to discern. Alright, so we'll go OK. And so those are my settings for the first column. The second column is going to be slightly different, and so will the third and fourth columns. These will all be the same. And because row formatting overrides column formatting, I'm not going to bother with formatting for these columns. And I'm not going to check override row settings because I'm going to let the row formatting settings override the column ones in this case. But the one thing that I will set is the width as percent. So I'm going to have four altogether. I've set the one at 15. Let's set this somewhere around 20. The program will automatically set this up for me once I have all of my columns set up. And the other thing that happens is once I have column 2 settings set up the way I want, with it highlighted, if I add another column and another column. I'm going to get a clone of this one so you can see that it's got 20%, 20%, 20%. So if you have a column highlighted and you've made all your settings here and you want to add another one that's exactly the same, just make sure it's highlighted and then go add. All right, so here's my columns. The first one that's going to be set up for my sort of header for the columns area, and then the columns that are actually going to be the ones that hold the numbers. So just to show you what this looks like, I'm going to click OK. And you're going to see I have four columns now, and the one set is blue. And if I type something in here, you'll see that it's going to put it in the middle. So it's picking up my settings. All right. So I've got the four columns now. So now I want to set up my four rows. So as I mentioned before, normally the formatting for the rows will override columns unless I've selected, as in the case of the first column here, override row settings. So let's go back into rows. And for the first row, it's going to be another one of my header rows. I'm not going to set it up as a title row because I don't want it to span the whole thing. I actually want to write numbers in here. This first one isn't going to be an answer row. But height, I will want to adjust that. So let's make that 60. Again, we can adjust that later on if that isn't exactly what I want. And again, I'm going to put the text in the center because I like the center. And we'll set up the color for this one to complement the column when it's all set up. Great, so that's my header row. And then row number two, the next three rows will all be the same. So what I need to do is set up row number two. And again, not a row column, I'm not going to change the name, but it will be an answer row. And I set the height of the top at 60. Maybe I'll set this as 70. And again, I'm going to set this as a center, and I'm going to leave it as white. Now that I have my settings for row two, I can add row three and add row four, and they all have the same settings as row two. So they were just cloned. And then of course row one is a little bit different. Okay, so now I should have four columns, four rows. Let's take a look at that. There we go. I've got my four columns, my four rows, and I've got my answer cells here. That's what this red mark is around here. That indicates that this cell is an answer. So let's quickly just set some data up in here. Or actually what we'll do is we'll take a look at this right now in document view just to see what that looks like. There we go. So I just need to put my information in. And you'll see that by default we have document numbering set up. So if I uncheck that and we go back here, you'll see that those letters are taken out. The choice is yours whether you want to use that or not. We'll just turn that on for now. And let's start by typing some things in. Let's go 2, 4, 6, and let's see, 3, 5, and 10. All right. So the answer here is going to be 6 and 12 and 18 and 10 and 20 and 30 and 20 and 40 and 60. All right. So we've got the data in here. Now let's take a look at in document view. So there we have our table. So multiply 2 times 3, and that's where the students would put the answers. And if I turn the answer key on, I have my answers displayed. Now at this point, I can start doing some formatting. Perhaps what I'd like to do is have a a slightly larger font in this. Maybe I want to, maybe I like the font, but maybe I'd like to center that in the cell. I mean, there's a lot of formatting that I can do afterwards with this if I want. But this just shows you quickly how you can set this up. So my answers are there. And if I switch to two columns, you'll see that it resizes the table for me automatically. And answer sheet view, if you're using an answer sheet, of course the answers will be there. So, there we go. That's just a quick introduction to setting up a table question. For more information, you can check out the help documentation for the program. So if you click on Home and you select Help Documentation, you can look for information about the different question items, like table question, or you can do a search for any of the terms that you might want some more information on. And of course, if you run into problems or have any questions, do contact us at support@schoolhousetech.com. And thank you for viewing this video of Schoolhouse Test 4.